In this example, we are required to find the half-life of uranium, and it is given that 3.32 into 10 to the power minus 7 gram of radium is found per gram of uranium in all minerals. We are also given the half-life of radium. Now, in this situation, we can directly write as in all minerals of uranium, amount of radium is constant, as it is given that the value is constant. This implies radium is in a radioactive equilibrium. This implies, here we can write lambda uranium n uranium must be equals to lambda radium n radium, which was the condition for radioactive equilibrium for an element. Its production rate must be equal to the decay rate. So, from here we can also relate number of atoms of uranium divided by half-life time of uranium must be equals to number of radium nuclei divided by the half-life of radium nuclei. So, half-life of uranium can be directly written in this situation. Nu by Nra multiplied by Tra. And number of nuclei can be directly calculated by mass and atomic mass, which can be written as mu atomic mass of radium by mass of radium multiplied by atomic mass of uranium multiplied by half-life of radium. Now, in this situation, when we substitute the values, it is given that per gram of uranium, this much amount of radium is there. So, we can take the mass of uranium to be 1 gram and atomic mass of radium here is 226 divided by 3.32 into 10 to the power minus 7 multiplied by mass number of uranium is 238 multiplied by 1600. On simplifying here, we'll get 4.7 into 10 to the power 9 years. That will be the answer to this problem. This is the half-life of uranium which is required here.